This is Jan, the global explorer. Hope you can hear me, for the tractor just passed me. In this video, I take a look at some places on southeastern Sjælland, Sjælland, who has connection to the famous Danish freedom fighter from the wars against Sweden in the 17th century. And this is the first place I will look at. This is Svend Gønge's hule, or at least it says so on the sign. The hule means hideout. So this is where Svend, who was, as I mentioned, a freedom fighter, hid out from the Swedes. It's been quite a bit down the road, so I haven't possibility to go down there, as my car is parked illegally. So, but if you go down there, you come to a place that's called Svend Gønges hule. I tell you more about Svend Gønge a bit later in the video. And now we are at Jungshoved Kirke, Jungshoved Church, a rather large church, as there's absolutely nothing close to this place, no villages, no nothing, or at least not very close to. But in the old days, there was a castle here, or a palace. And in the novel about Svend Gønge, a novel written by a man called Carit Edber, Svend Gønge saves the Queen of Denmark, who is hunting in the forest that was here in the old days. And she's on her way to this castle. And she asks him to come the next day to receive some whatever she's giving him. I don't remember exactly what, but a reward of some kind. And the sign just tell a bit about Gøngehøvdingen and his connection to Jungshoved Slot, Jungshoved Palace. So most of it, what's in the novel at least, is fiction. But he did actually, that is Svend Gønge, did actually visited Jungshoved Slot. He was a captain in the army. He started out as a captain, as I was about to mention, he was a captain in the Danish army and commanded a regiment of Gønger, that is people from his own homeland, which was in Sweden, or rather today it's in Sweden. In the old days it was Danish. Later he took part in the defense of Copenhagen during the siege, the Swedish siege of Copenhagen, and he was awarded a manor down close to here. And I guess I will visit the manor, or rather the manor's gone, but the small village where the manor was situated at the end of this video. Well, this is actually all that remains of the palace. That is the hill in the background, on top of which the manor was built. It's, as you can see, the waters here are very narrow, and as it was both a palace and a castle, there were guns here, and they were able to control whoever wanted to enter these very narrow waters. But as I'm running out of battery, I guess I will end this video here and continue when I get to Lundby, where the manor house was. And this is Lundbygård that Svend Gønge owned from 1661 to 1672. And I will end this video here. If you want to learn more about Svend Gønge, I will very soon post an article on my homepage, www.kronsel.net. I will put the address in the description, and when I post the article, I will also put a link to that. Anyway, I have been Jan, the Global Explorer. Thank you for watching. This video about Svend Gønge, very short video. If you want to watch more videos from me, press the subscribe button and click the bell in order to get alerted whenever I upload new videos.